How's it going, guys? Peep is
pizza
here. And watching WestJett and Average Jonas beef all the time is like watching a street kid and a corpo fight. We're talking about the beef of a century in a video game, at least. WestJett versus Average Jonas. Why do these two creators absolutely hate each other? Now, first, we're gonna have to take it all the way back to the beginning, because this beef has been going on way longer than you think. So remember that whole corpo comment I made on Average Jonas? Well, truth is, Average Jonas has a personality to maintain. I hate to call Average Jonas a shill, but truth is, it's very obvious that like Valorant pays him a decent paycheck. You think this dude voluntarily buys all of these skins? Like, let's be dead ass here. Kind of gets special treatment for everything, making songs for Valorant, getting invited to everything for Valorant. You know, he has to put on his best suit, right? He has to stay professional. He needs to have a likable, charismatic personality, which is exactly why when a creator like WestJett makes a slightly overboard joke, then it's only right for Average Jonas to go on all fours after WestJett. This all started after a couple of comments. In 2021, WestJett dropped a ranking every sheriff skin video. I mean, he only uploads one of these like every 2 hours, maybe? I don't know. And he makes this comment. Polly, play the clip.
Next on the list, I had to go with the Jet Sheriff. Now, you might be wondering, why is the Jet Sheriff rated lower than the Sova Sheriff? Well, I got a quick answer for you. It's actually because Average Jonas, who's actually a drug lord, transferred me $700,000 if I rated the Sova Sheriff higher than the Jet.
And that's the comment. Very obvious a joke. If Average Jonas was actually laundering money through WestJett, he would have made a Walter White, "You got me," comment.
You got me.
Unfortunately, Average Jonas is the father figure of Valorant, so he had to man up for himself. Average Jonas proceeds to tell WestJett to grow up, because he's never going to make it in the YouTube scene if he maintains comments like this. I'm gonna be fully honest with you, this kind of a response is a serious ego play. There are so many creators who have horrible senses of humor that are absolutely blew up, like bam, here's one, here's another, here's that one, here's this one. All of these guys blew up because they had horrible senses of humor. No offense, Average Jonas, but if you want to succeed on YouTube, getting on your knees for a billion-dollar company is completely optional. Like, that is not required. Now, WestJett being WestJett, he's going to continue making stupid jokes like that, because he's not going to pull a, "I'm sorry, sir, it won't happen again." Like, no, it's WestJett's sense of humor. He's just going to keep doing this. WestJett being WestJett, he's going to continue having a shitty sense of humor. And this just pissed off Average Jonas even more. If I was to sum up this entire controversy, I think it's just Average Jonas takes the game way too seriously. Like, this Valorant shit is ride or die, man. You ain't ready for these streets, cuh. You about to see the pop in your ass side of Valorant. Truth is, this entire drama is just one long Darman episode. Honestly, the reason a lot of people side with WestJett in this situation is because, well, yeah, I have no doubts about his community being warm and toxic-free. That's not what everyone says about him. Whenever you hear someone talking about their experiences with Average Jonas, whether it's being another content creator or someone who just happens to run into him in a comp game, they all say the exact same thing. His ego is too big. He takes himself way too seriously. Like, here's a clip from Amin on PC where they were playing a custom game. Let me emphasize that. They were playing a custom game with other creators. You know, the game mode you're not really supposed to take seriously. It's just for fun.
Can we play normally, please?
Jonas, you're not having fun?
I just think it's like fun once or twice, but the games get so unserious. Unless you're making like a very weird video.
Ever, you ain't built for these streets, cuz Valorant's ride or die. Average Jonas is like that manager at McDonald's that treats that shit like it's military boot camp. I know she make a mean frappe, bro. Sheesh. Average Jonas has low-key become like a bit of a laughing stock in the Valorant community ever since. Mainly because, well, he just takes the game way too seriously. A lot of people call him out for stuff like, oh, the age gap between him and his wife is a little absurd. People also call you out for hugging and touching Sage Mommy more than your own wife. Like, it just looks weird, man. I'm sorry. Especially if the age gap between the women you talk to is like a decade, then it gets a little weird, man. Like, you can't blame me. So if I was to sum up this entire video, huge ego, takes everything too seriously, and people just don't like him for that. So that's why I'm gonna go now. So see ya. Boom!